Let's bring in Fox News contributor, former Utah Congressman Jason Chaffetz, joining us now. Jason, you've been following along with us. What struck you as you listened to William Barr this morning on Capitol Hill?
I think perhaps the most explosive and consequential thing that the attorney general said is that he is going to look at the genesis of how this investigation started, that the inspector general's report coming in the May-June timeframe, that has very serious implications. Number two, I do think that the Democrats are going to try to muddy the waters. They've tried to undercut the legs of the attorney general. I think he put that and dismissed that, put that to bed very adeptly. They tried to create this scene that says that the attorney general went rogue and went off on his own. But obviously, there was collaboration with the deputy attorney general and the attorney general in those discussions in the summary that was issued by the attorney general. So that talking point from the Democrats, I think, is dead and off the charts now as well.
You also found this comment about the inkling as to what the special counsel was up to. Why is that? We talked to Ken Starr about that 10 minutes ago. Why is that so important, Jason?
Well, the Democrats seem to think that they just took this 300-400-page report, whatever it is, and then, 48 hours later, you just wrote a summary. That was not the case. He used the word inkling several times, giving indication that they were given a heads up along the way, along the progress. Remember, Rod Rosenstein was supposed to leave mid-March. The attorney general asked him to stay on. He did stay on. And so there was the continuity of that communication that was then used to generate this summary report. And again, it totally undercuts what the Democrats have been trying to say, which is that this summary is bogus. They still want some salacious detail out of this thing, but I don't think they're ever going to get
just
it.
Just to follow up on that, he said the first letter, March 24th, that was the Sunday afternoon letter. He believes that was shared with Mueller's team. The next letter, 5 days later, March 29th, was not reviewed by Mueller's team. Does that tie into any sort of significance, Jason?
Yeah, the idea that he was going to share the first letter with Mueller, Mueller refuses, says, I don't need to see it, I think shows that they have a good working relationship, a good confidence. And obviously, the attorney general is not going to go out on a limb when he simultaneously is saying, I'm going to release as much of the full report as I possibly can. Democrats can try to beat their heads against the wall as long as they can and try to say that there's some little detail in there. But the bottom line is there's no more prosecutions and there is nothing to their notion that they have been just barking on for 2 years that there was some sort of collusion with the Trump campaign. It just was never there.
What do you think is going to be the big takeaway? You know, having seen this play out in the hearing room this morning, Jason, for the American people to see this report scrutinized and questioned in such a public way, and now to hear that even the report with the redactions, William Barr's working with Robert Mueller to do just that. You know, will Democrats ultimately accept the findings of this report?
No, I don't think they will. But you know what? The United States of America is unique. We're different. We are self-critical. We go through these gyrations in this country, unlike most any other country on the planet. And it makes our process better. But at some point, I think the American people are going to take a deep breath and say the Democrats have been trying to sell us this collusion for 2 years. There was nothing to it. And even if Adam Schiff and Swalwell and the others want to try to say, oh, well, I've seen it, nobody else has. They don't even have a witness to it. And so this report, it is vital. But again, the most serious, consequential, and explosive thing will come in May or June when we hear from the inspector general about what happened in the genesis of spying on a political campaign. Yeah. That is by far the bigger story.
Jason Chaffetz, thank you for your time, for your analysis there.